This is a video walkthrough explaining our procedure for equine dentistry. First, the horse must be sedated, and a full mouth speculum is applied to the mouth. This speculum allows us to open the mouth to the desired width. We have a bright mouth light that is placed on the speculum that allows the mouth to be better visualized, especially the rear teeth. We wash out the mouth with an antiseptic rinse prior to the procedure. This removes feed material, which is often packed into the chewing surfaces of the teeth. It is difficult to fully evaluate the mouth if there is any feed material remaining. A complete exam of the mouth is done visually first. We're looking for any sharp enamel points that may be causing ulcerations on the tongue and cheeks. This horse demonstrates cheek lesions being caused by sharp enamel points on the upper arcades. There are four dental arcades, two on the top, two on the bottom, each consisting of six teeth. We will evaluate each arcade for even wearing, loose teeth, spaces between the teeth that may be packing feed, and teeth that are abnormally tall or have hooks, which do not allow the mouth to move freely. We use a powered dental float, which has a rotating diamond bit on the end of a long shaft. This tool allows us to make dental corrections quickly and painlessly. We use it to first remove all sharp points, which generally occur on the cheek sides of the upper teeth and the tongue side of the lower teeth. This occurs normally on all horses due to their side-to-side chewing action, coupled with the lifting apart of the teeth as the mouth reopens. Horses' teeth are continually growing to replenish themselves, to replace the tooth that is worn down from constant grinding. This continual growth will allow sharp points and abnormal wear to compound themselves if not corrected. Watch closely as we demonstrate the removal of these enamel points off the cheek teeth side of the uppers and the tongue side of the lowers. Bit seats are created on the front corners of the first cheek teeth. It is thought that by removing this sharp corner that pain may be avoided when the bit pulls the soft tissue of the lips up against the corner. All teeth are shaped, being careful to avoid disrupting the chewing surfaces of the teeth with the float. The table surface of the tooth is not touched unless the tooth is abnormally tall and needs to be made shorter. If the canine teeth are tall and sharp, they will be reduced in size. These teeth have no function other than for fighting and biting. The diamond bit is moved from tooth to tooth, being careful not to spend too much time on one tooth, which prevents excessive heat from building up on the teeth during this process. We will then rinse the mouth and take another look to see if all needed corrections have been made. Once that is done, the teeth will be felt by hand to see if there is any sharp areas that were missed, and to check for any sharp areas that cannot be seen from the front. This is also a good time to wiggle each and every tooth and to make sure that none are loose. Some horses will have a sharp point on the back side of the upper tooth where the float cannot reach. In this case, we will pass a slim hand float with a special angle to help reach those points. Now a final check of the arcades are done. We're checking to see that the arcades are level and that they possess the proper angulation, that all sharp points have been removed. We will also assess any problem areas and the corrections that have been made Since some tall teeth cannot be taken down fully in one visit due to the danger of pulp exposure, a recommendation will be made for when a follow-up procedure should be done if needed. The speculum will be cranked down and then removed from the mouth. The incisors will be evaluated at this point. While the horse may appear to be quite sleepy, most horses are very steady on their feet, and most will be ready to trailer home in about 15 minutes. The line of the incisors should be straight across. Any slopes or abnormal wearing will be corrected as best as possible. The jaws are then moved side to side to simulate chewing. Their jaws should be free to slide both directions, and as the cheek teeth make contact, the incisors should lift apart. This relationship is evaluated both directions, and any incisors that are too long or that are causing impingement of free movement are reduced. Equine dentistry is extremely important to the longevity of your horse. While most horses will not need to have dentistry performed every year, we recommend that you have their mouth evaluated annually so that abnormal wearing can be identified and corrected as quickly as possible.